So we have finished with vocabulary. I'm going to move forward to spelling. And you know, okay, in the weekly plan, I have sent you all the pages that are included in this exam, okay? Of course, in this worksheet, I have given some examples, okay? But we have a lot of words that you have to be able to spell, to write, and to know the meaning. And you know, my famous message on the groups always, it's not only about spelling the words, you have to know the meaning of each word. The outcome of the contest is still uncertain. We are not certain of that thing, so we're going to say uncertain. We're going to have the word certain, then we're going to add the prefix an here. A prefix is a group of words, or I'm sorry, a group of letters that we add at the beginning of the word, okay, to give maybe the opposite of the word or something else, because we're going to study many different kinds of prefixes. So where did I go? Let's carry on here. Your bike is in a state of disrepair. When you repair something, you fix it. When you disrepair something, or something is in a state of disrepair, some people, they say it cannot be fixed even. I enjoy a cool on a hot day. I enjoy a cool refreshment, okay? I enjoy a cool refreshment. Here we are talking about the Pepsi, the Coca-Cola, any can that you like to drink, okay? That's what we call refreshment. You have to pay attention to the way we spell the words. I got a wrong number when I misdialed the phone number. When you dial the number, okay, the verb, the first verb is to dial. You have the phone like this, and you have the numbers here. You're going to dial, for example, 054-6621. So that's the meaning of to dial the number, okay? When you add miss, which is a prefix, okay, it's going to give the total opposite to that word, okay, or to that verb. To misdial is to write in a wrong way, to write the number in a wrong way. This is the way we write misdial. Of course, we have a lot of words. I cannot go through all the words, okay? You have to go back. I'm merely helping you. Choose the correct answer. Choose the correct contraction. Here, I have told you before that the biggest problem with the contractions is will not. Because a lot of people, they're going to do this. Whoa, we have not. Okay, teacher said that we're going to move the N here and to omit the O. And it's going to be willent, I swear to God. أقسم بالله العلي العظيم. I can't remember, was it grade 5 or grade 6? I think it was grade 6, okay? I think it was grade 6. Someone in grade 6, we have studied it now. And we have finished with it. And I have asked them, okay, do you have any problems with contractions? And because contractions and negatives, everyone is going to say, whoa, easy, easy, forget about it. I'm not going to commit a mistake. And I asked him, after like 10 to 15 minutes, okay, what is the contraction of will not, or the negative of will is will not, and the contraction is won't, of course. He said it's willent, and I was about to cry, okay, because he didn't pay attention to teacher, okay. So here, of course, it's not hasn't, okay? Hasn't is the contracted form, of course, of has not. I want you to pay attention here to something. The contracted form of had is apostrophe D, and the contracted form of would is apostrophe D too. Okay, both, they have the same contracted form. Pay attention to is, has, and, is, has, and as. They have the same contracted form, apostrophe S. For example, he is going to be his. He has is going to be his too. And let us, for example, to invite someone to do something. For example, let's play. Okay, for example, okay, let us is going to be let's too. Okay. The others, you have the book, you have to go through every and each contraction, okay, in the book. I am, we're going to omit the A. You are, we're going to omit the A, okay? For example, cannot is going to be can't, should not is going to be shouldn't. You have to revise all of those. Then, choose the correct contraction. Toad should not go on adventure alone. Of course, we're talking about Todd of Super Mario. I love Super Mario. So, should not is going to be shouldn't. Here, I didn't want to make it hard for you, okay? I put has, which is obviously wrong. Won't, which is obviously wrong. So, it's going to be shouldn't. Choose the correct adjective. John went to the busy story to pick up red... John went to the busy story? No, to the busy store. Okay, to the busy store to pick up red apples. Of course, here I have apples, which is the noun, and I have told you that an adjective is going to give us more information about a noun, okay? So here we are talking about the red apples. Do you remember, my boys, when we were talking about the three questions, which one the answer is going to be this, those, that, and these, okay? And then we move on to how many, okay? The answer is going to be either a number or many, several, some, or few, okay? Then we move on to the question, what kind? Those are the three questions about adjectives, okay, in English, okay, for professionals, of course. What kind of apples are you talking about, teacher? I'm talking about the red ones. I'm talking about the red apples. So red is the adjective here. So, choose the correct article. We used to live in an or a city. Of course, here you have to pay attention that the word starts with a consonant. So, we're going to put a. We have said that with a word that starts with a consonant, you're going to use the article a. It's an indefinite article. We are talking about any city, okay? Whatever city. It's not a unique thing. It's not a city that we have already talked about. If it was a unique city or a city that we have talked we have already talked about, we're going to use the, of course, the definite article. However, some people are going to say, but teacher, why didn't we use an? I'm going to answer them and say, you didn't attend my class. That's why I'm going to re-explain it to you. With an, we're going to add, we're going to use an with words that start with vowels. And to remember the vowels, you have the happy face, okay, O, E, A, I is the nose, and U is the mouth. However, please pay attention to this. When a word starts with a U, and we pronounce it a U, okay, it's an exception. We're going to say a union, not an union, okay? However, when it starts with a U, and that U is pronounced a, just like an unexpected men came in, for example, okay, we're going to use an, not a, okay? Pay attention to this too, please. With H, okay, whenever you have, for example, a hotel, because we pronounce it ha, we're going to use a. However, if we do not pronounce it, if it's a silent H, we're going to say an honest man, because we do not pronounce the H here. I hope that through those three videos, I have helped you a lot. If you have any questions, I'm going to be glad to help you and to answer your questions. Thank you so much. See you on Sunday, God willing. I love you all. Great four. Goodbye.